to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I think we all know what's next. Can I get approval for the agenda? Motion by Treasurer Day, second by Secretary Auger. Is there any discussion on the agenda?
Yes.
I see President Kenyon.
I'd just like to strike item B from speakers, Mr. Speaker, because he is going to come to the next meeting.
Okay. All right, can I get a second for that?
Second
by Secretary Auger. Any discussion on that? All those in favor of striking B on speaker, say aye.
Aye.
All those against, say nay. Opposed? Any abstentions? All right. Any other discussion on the agenda? With no further discussion on the agenda, we move on to the approval of minutes of November 28, 2012.
Motion.
I'm going way too quick, guys. Once a break has got me like that. All those in favor of approving the agenda as amended, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no. Abstentions. Our agenda is passed. And with our agenda being passed, we're going to move on to the approval of minutes of November 28th.
Motion, second.
Motion by Treasurer Day, second by Vice President Costa. Is there any discussion on the minutes? With no discussion on the minutes, all those in favor of approving the minutes, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no. Abstentions. Motion. Abstention. Representative Sanchez. And the motion passes. We're going to move on to speakers, and we're going to go on to the lovely Kate Brazina, the Executive Director of Alumni Affairs.
Hello, everyone. Travis, thank you for saying my last name correctly.
No problem.
I just wanted to thank you all for letting me come tonight. I noticed some familiar faces in the crowd. I came in last January, and I had just been here at Rhode Island College for about 2 months, and I remember coming in and talking with you all about homecoming and not really knowing who was in the audience, but just kind of looking around, I recognized some of you from participating in homecoming activities last fall, also just, you know, being around campus and going into Donovan and all of that. So I thank you for letting me come tonight. The reason why I'm here is we are planning homecoming 2013. We've scheduled it for the first week of October, which is October 2nd through the 5th of 2013. Last year, after talking with several student groups, also with some of our alums and our faculty and staff, what we tried to do was integrate all of our activities and include student-driven activities into the entire week. I think the event that you probably most remember most is the Group Boston event. How many people went to that? Okay. And we started off the week with an event in Donovan. It was the pizza cook-off, which Gianna helped with, and that was really great to see many of you there. Friday night, we had a parade with golf carts. How many of you participated in that? That's fun. So I'm hoping that we're going to bring that back again. But many of the people that were very involved in the planning of homecoming on the student side are graduating this year. So I need as much help from this group as I can to get plans up and running. I'm having a baby soon, so I'm going to be leaving. I'm leaving in about a month. And what I'd like to do while I'm out is our interim assistant director, Sharon Hartley, would like to meet with the student group at least once to twice before the end of May so that we can get plans in place for homecoming and have all of the plans set if we need to do any kind of budgetary passing for different events or if there's going to be any concerts like Group Boston. We want to work with Dr. Penfield and his team and make sure that that's something that we can look at doing again for homecoming. If so, we want to make sure that we have the finances straightened out so that we can really promote it and do the best that we can in making sure that homecoming 2013 is a success. Obviously, the audience for homecoming is our students, our alumni, and our faculty and staff. One of the things that we're going to try this year that we didn't do enough of last year is really looking at some of our affinity events for alumni. So Saturday, it could be that we have a student community government alumni event, or we have a WXIN alumni event, or maybe a theater event. And if we do that, what I'd really like to do is work with the students here. If you are a current student, let's say in WXIN, it would be great to have you calling our alums and trying to get them to come back to campus, say on Saturday. They're gonna respond better to you versus me. So I think that that's really important. So there will be an alumni student connection with all things for homecoming 2013, but we need as much help as we can get. And Kyla, I don't know what you suggest, but how many committee members do you think we should have for executing homecoming?
I mean, I don't know. I would say, as many as we wanted for this year, I think. I don't think we really set anything when we talked earlier. I would say whoever's interested, please let me know after the meeting. I'll be interning with Alumni Affairs again this year while Kate's gone. So if you're interested, please let me know, and I'll make sure that her and Sharon both get a list. And then we'll see what kind of volunteer, I guess, we have this year, and then go from there for next year.
Yeah, I mean, the larger the committee, I think the better.
Right.
Both. We're going to have a student committee, we'll have an alumni committee, and then we'll also have faculty and staff involved. Because it's a lot. There's a lot of balls up in the air with it, and we want to make sure that we give you all a good experience. Does anyone have any questions for me on homecoming and any suggestions for next year?
Yes.
Sign me up.
All right. I like that.
No, I mean, if you guys want, you can come to me after the meeting, it's fine.
But right now I see Gianna and Caitlin definitely have interest.
Be here.
And freshmen over here. Freshmen and sophomores, because we need, I mean, the more people we have in those younger groups, I think is really important.
I think it's important, just by looking at what we do with Roof Boston, I think it's important to get something for homecoming for our students before we all leave in May. Because we have about 1,000, 1,200 freshmen that all go through freshman orientation and those nighttime activities that we do in the community. And we really can promote this event that they can buy the tickets during the summer while they're here. So we already know we have an audience prior to classes beginning, and we can advertise it when classes begin, because I think we were a little late this year. I would say it was a Herculean effort in Facebook and Twitter and all those social media things that you guys do that got the word out, and I think that's how we were so successful. But we don't have to do that if we can get something booked prior to you guys leaving in May.
Didn't you have almost 1,000 kids? I mean, that's great.
And you advertise it over 2 weeks versus we could advertise this over 2 or 3 months.
And the same with the parade. I'd love to be at, you know, as the kids are coming in, getting all the golf carts set up and making sure that people are registered early. So any ideas that you have, what we'd like to do is by the time you leave, have everything set, have the entire agenda of events set, so that way we can help and promote it as best we can.
Treasurer Day?
I just want to say, like, I know having worked with Group Boston, and I know that Kyla and I and Gianna and Hillary, and I know Travis and Brian have agreed that we really would like to see Group Boston here again, no doubt in our minds, and that's something that I think we're hoping to pursue as soon as possible. So Parliament, obviously we'd ask for your approval again, see if you're still interested in doing it after the results from the fall. But hopefully this is something that will get run by and approved sometime soon. So, and I'm hoping as a person who's had experience will be here in the fall that I'll be able to still work on that.
Given that budgets are due soon, is it something that you would put in your budget as a homecoming item?
Theoretically we could, but at this time I would just recommend us allocating it out of our escrow account, which would be able to cover it. Which is something that it's more internal discussion, but I mean, I'm giving them a report next week about that. That's something that doesn't have anything to do with actual homecoming. So.
Representative Anderson.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I just wanted to throw out there that like the importance of something like homecoming, this opportunity to have an alumni event, because what's not inherently really obvious is that when you're meeting alumni, you're meeting people who are working. And these are people who are working, if they're, you're in the same organization, they're alumni of that, they might be working in that field. They might be working somewhere that you really want to work, and that could be finding that RIC connection that gets you the full-time job and something like that. Because I just, I was gonna talk about it later, but I just got a full-time job at GTEC, and I'm working in communications and PR. My degree's in HR management, and I minored in math. So there, I really like, I didn't study communications, but I was part of XIN, and I was part of the anchor, and I found an alumni who was part of that as well, and I reached out to her, and that's how I got the job. So this is really an opportunity to bring those people back and have a couple resumes handy, make business cards for free online, you can do that, and maybe get an internship over the summer or in the spring and just try it out. You won't be disappointed. The worst they'll say is no.
Yeah, Barry was at our last event that we had. We had a holiday event at David Buster, so it was good to see you there, and it's good to see you here tonight. But I do think that if we have these affinity events, say a WXIN event on Saturday, integrating the student piece is so important. And just know that when you do go to these events, and when you are talking with recent grads, or those that might have graduated 20 years before you, that you could be having an informational interview. That, you know, just know that, that these people are going to remember you, and if you need to meet somebody for coffee, you know, a couple months later, because you're looking for a way into a certain business, it's definitely a foot in the door. So we want to provide that opportunity for you. And I think last year there was a lot of alumni events separate, a lot of student events separate, but we want to integrate them as best as we can. And we need your opinions on that, and your ideas and feedback, and we'll certainly listen to you and do what we can to make it a good experience for everyone.
Thank you, Kate.
Right? Thank you. And welcome back, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your meeting.
Thank you. I'm not going to say no.
Dr. Kane's like, help me.
Anyone here for open forum? Anyone here for open forum? Anyone here for open forum? We don't want to hear open forum. We're going to move on to office of announcements. President Beckett.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have a lot to say, guys, so I'm going to do my best to keep it succinct, but bear with me, please. First, I want to say happy birthday, Jordan.
Woo!
She already sang two once. She doesn't like being sung to, so no one can sing her. And I'd also like to welcome our new members, Rebecca and Justin. Just Rebecca right now, though, because I don't see Justin unless there's a leave. But welcome, Rebecca. We're very happy to have you. I just wanted to update you on the ASL policy that I've been working on per Mr. Sanchez's suggestion last semester. I met with Carrie Rossi over the break, and I think she offered me a lot of insight. I actually left with a giant folder filled with all kinds of wonderful things. And what I realized is that it's not just going to be a change just in our office. It's going to be a change, you know, Gianna's going to send out some kind of paperwork to the student orgs. She's going to introduce it at one of her roundtables about how to handle students with disabilities and things like that. What is going to happen is, I'll have a final copy for you guys next week. I want Carrie to look at it again first. There's going to be a sheet similar to what they have already in disability services for students requiring ASL interpreters for academic reasons, but ours is going to be the other side of it. So if you are a student that requires ASL interpretation, you're going to come to our office, you're going to fill out the form, and it'll go right to Joan, and Joan will request the service for you. A copy will also go to the student org as long as that student checks the box and says, yes, that's okay for them to know. All the information is going to be kept private. I'm barely going to know about it. It's going to be all complete and all there. And every semester, Carrie's going to send Joan an email about how many students have registered for ASL services that semester. I'm not interested in knowing names. I'm not interested in knowing Apple IDs. I'm not interested in knowing any of that. All I need to know is numbers. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a line item in our budget for $1,000 for the year. Because right now there are only, I want to say Carrie told me, two or three students that are registered, and only one has shown interest in attending meetings. So I think $1,000 for right now will be plenty. As far as updates on all the other resolutions, there are five of them. And this is kind of going hand in hand with what I'm going to say. I just want to say that, you know, last semester, I didn't see it really as a failure. I saw us as making a lot of progress. But what I had a problem with is that week after week after week, one week where there is not one member of my board on the agenda, and there was nobody else on it. I think one of the very first weeks Mr. Taylor was on it with the Commuter Student Association, or was that last year?
That was last year,
even worse. I don't know. I don't want you guys to think I'm scolding you, but I'm just really disappointed. Like, not only are we an empty body, but we also don't do anything. Like, that's ridiculous. I don't understand. Like, I don't know what else to do. I offered you guys an opportunity to make a logo for a sweatshirt. I offered you a $100 book card for free for just submitting a design for a sweatshirt, and not one person did it. Not one person did it. I don't get that. I have to start holding people accountable, and obviously that is my job as the president. Perhaps I didn't do that as well as I could have last semester, but just be aware, guys, that I will withhold your stipends. I don't want to have to come down to that. I would really like to give everybody the benefit of the doubt and say that you would be here with or without me paying you, but it's really gotten to the point where I'm going to have to do it if you don't do work. It's just, we're stretched too thin. We have really strong personalities. We don't like to delegate, and that's what we're going to have to start doing, because we can't do it all by ourselves. There's just too much to do, and that's what you guys are here for. That being said, this is what's going to happen. I've split up the resolutions, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them right now. One of them we're going to take care of ourselves, because it really should be an executive board matter. But we have a gym guest resolution policy, something to that effect. We have students that would like to park in C-Lot. We have that as a resolution. We had a resolution come through where we'd like printers in the dorms. We have a resolution coming up tonight, which Vice President Costa will explain to you. And we had a resolution come up at the last Parliament meeting about advertising and Donovan. There are 17 of you. So what I'm asking you to do is, I've split you up into groups, and very simple, designate a contact person in the group, a group leader. You're all going to report to my chief of staff, or if I tell you specifically to Hillary or Brian, that's who you report to. And on February 20th, I'd like an update as far as where those resolutions are, because I don't personally have time to run around and do every single one. I've done them halfway. I think I've left you all at a very good starting point. I'm giving you over 3 weeks to do it. It should not be a difficult thing for you to do to get me an update. And if you need a contact person, please ask me. Yes, Mr. Taylor.
Are you
Taylor.
Forcing us into a certain resolution? Is that what you're implying?
I'm asking you all to mingle and talk to each other, because please take this seriously, Mr. Taylor.
I raised his card, that's why I left. I'm sorry.
Okay, no, but I'm just really asking that you take this seriously, because I can't do this by myself. The four of us can't do it by ourselves. They don't have office hours all the time. They can't do it by themselves either. We're just really stretched thin, and these are ideas that you guys have come up with.
I understand, but I didn't back any of those things myself, so if I didn't support them, I should be forced into it.
I'm not forcing anybody into it. This is your job.
Hold on.
It's not a back and forth discussion.
These are my announcements.
All right. Let President Becky finish her announcements, and then we'll field questions.
Just to that effect, though, these are things that students are asking for. You represent students, so you should support these items. I don't see why you would object to student parking spots in C-Lot. I don't know why you would object to students bringing a guest to the gym. Just because you didn't support it, you didn't sign your name on it, you still voted yes. Not one of these resolutions was voted down. It was unanimous, every single one. So that to me says you support it. That's all I'm saying. And if honestly, if you have a problem and you don't want to be here anymore, I don't know what to tell you. I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you. This is what I have to do. So as far as the C-Lot committee goes, I have Tom on there because he's already on parking and traffic. I have Tyler, I have Rebecca, and I have Ashley. And you'll be reporting to Ryan. I'm not asking you guys to bend over backwards here. Just contact people. The reason why it didn't go through, I spoke to Vice President Gearhart, and it was tabled in committee because of lack of information. All you have to do is find the information for me.
Can I respond? Yes, I was on the committee. The committee actually never met. They just emailed, and they're actually looking for me. I was going to bring this up in Parliament. They're looking for what direction they want to do. Mm-hmm. So they basically offered me a compromise to take back to Parliament, saying that it would just be an open parking lot. So I'll be in contact with Ryan.
Good. That's all I want. That's all I want, guys. I just want an update. I can't do all this legwork myself. The guest resolution policy. Marcy was a sponsor of it, so I'm going to put her on that. I have Katie, I have Alyssa,
on that. So just look into it, research it. That's all I'm asking. As far as the printing, Laura's not here tonight. Ray's not here, but I have Mr. Sanchez on that committee. I figured if I put all the resident students together, since it was a resident reflective resolution, that would work. As far as this new Whipple policy that, or I guess resolution, I'm sorry, that Hillary is introducing tonight, I have Kevin, I have Tim, and I have Justin, and you'll be reporting to Hillary. And as far as the Donovan banners go, I have Mr. Taylor, Mr. Santuri, and I have Carly. All I want is information. I'm not asking for anything definite. Just help me do legwork. That's it. This does not go above and beyond what your duties are. And as far as anything else goes, if you have ideas, if you would like to bring them to Parliament, if you have language for a resolution, please bring it to one of us before it goes to Parliament. The resolutions we've gotten so far were good. They're wonderful ideas. We just need to learn how to word them more strongly so they're more effective and someone gets charged with doing them. And as far as that goes, that's all set. So if you have any questions after the meeting, if you'd like a copy of your resolution, feel free to come up to me. Feel free to ask me for it. All I'm asking you to do is some legwork. That's it. Let's see. What else has been gotten done? The other thing is, I don't know who lives in Weber or Brown or Thorpe or Willard. Ashley, you do. I asked Brian Lally to have communal trash cans put next to the recycling bins. Are those there?
They are.
How are
they
working?
Wonderful.
Wonderful. An example of something that got done that Laura brought to us with the resolution. Thank you for that. And as far as Res Life goes, I've been talking to Brian Lally, and I'm asking them to be a little more transparent because I feel like everybody has all these questions that lives in the dorms and they're never answered properly. So as a result, Res Life will be putting out a survey, and you'll also be able to evaluate your RAs in the survey with a couple of questions. So I think that's very important. Some of the things we're working on this semester is the library hours. We have various other policy changes. We're working on getting more things to pass out to students. And of course, we're looking to fill these seats. So if you know anybody that would be interested, please send them up to us. And that concludes my announcements, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, President. Thank you. Representative Taylor, did you have any? Representative Costa?
I'll pass.
Okay. With that, we're going to move on to Vice President Hillary Costa.
Okay, everyone, I have a gift for you. It's a Parliament email, yay! All right, well, I'm going to pass these out, and I'll explain while passing them out. They were all organized nicely, too. Milton, don't put the camera over here. All right, Nate, this is yours. Ashley, this is yours.
Thank you.
Kevin. All right, so these emails were created, and I have on here your username is to the left and password is to the right, and the server to enter these in is you type in your browser email.ricseg.org, and it should show up, and then you have the login space from there. You can obviously alter your password after you get in. I appreciate it if you all could log into this and send me an email so I know that everything's up and running. So that means the Executive Council's emails are theirofficeat.org. So Tyler checked in with me today, our new comptroller, he checked in because now our cabinet has new emails, so, sorry, it's an example. He checked in with me today about his email working, so he's all set. He even said hooray, and he was that excited. So just shoot me an email really quick. You can just put period, I don't care, just so I know that it works and then that you're doing well. And I would hope that you would use this as an email to tell your constituents to email to if they have any issues. Just wanted to let you know we have merchandise in the works. Our communications director, Caitlin Hearn, has been very busy at work. We're working on iPhone cases for the 4, 4S, and 5. Those are we're gonna get in the small amount to use to, what's the matter? Those are in the works. I know we were also thinking about doing 3-pointed highlighters, and we also have this new t-shirt slogan that I would love to share. It is, forget Republicans and Democrats, we're one big party. So look for something like that. We're just trying to make us not such a serious face. I mean, because at the end of the day, we're an extracurricular activity, and we all like to have fun sometimes. So, all right, fine, be silent. So, and we also have our newsletter is completed, our fall newsletter. I sent that to Marissa Weiss, and that will be blasted next week with the student activities briefs. My next PR committee meeting, I just combined committee and meeting, is February 11th. The elections meeting is February 13th. The Beverly McGinnis scholarship application will be available on February 18th, and that'll be available till mid-March. I'll keep announcing it for you. As far as the Donovan digital banners resolution, I sent an email before school started to Arthur and Vinny, and I'm having a meeting with them tomorrow. If any of my PR members who are present here would like to attend, please let me know. And next, very important, next Wednesday, February 6th, is Student Activities Day. I know a lot of you are involved in other clubs and organizations, but make sure you also play up student community government if you're not going to be at our table as well, or stop by or bring some of your club members over. So, what? Oh, following Wednesday. I think you're thinking next Wednesday is February 6th, but 2 weeks from today. And that concludes my announcements.
Thank you, Vice President Costa. We'll move on to Secretary Auger.
Hi, welcome back. Stopped working really hard for planning Storgies. Still getting a bunch of constitutions in. Other than that, enjoy the rest of the meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Secretary Auger, for your announcements. Judge Roday.
So, a couple of things. I'll give you an update on where we are with funding and financing sometime next week. And by sometime next week, I mean department. That'll include any deposits made in the fall semester, where we stand right now, when we're anticipating our next deposit, how much finance has allocated between last semester and this first meeting. This first meeting was short, kind of speak to the point today. I think we had a good time. The timeshare is still available. If anybody wants it, it's $700. We need to know by February 1st, and you need to come in with money in hand and turn it over, and we'll gladly lend it to you. You're buying. Moral of the story is, if you're interested in it, please let me know, and let's see if we can get you up to the office and hand over $700 to pay for it.
Treasure Day,
yes?
Would you like to sort of notify some of the members what we're talking about under the timeshare?
The timeshare is a timeshare up in Loon Mountain. we bought it back in 1989, 90 something, before I was born. And I'm 23, so it's old. sorry guys. Really funny. It's really nice. It's in New Hampshire, and you get it from a Saturday to a Saturday. It's the week of spring break. And it's a good opportunity to get away from Rhode Island. So that's all I have on the timeshare. Speaker Escobar.
It's also a timeshare.
Also, it's a timeshare. Yes.
Okay. No, thank you.
No, I'm not done. Dr. Keen has something to add.
Questions on if we, I'm trying to remember if I saw an ad at the Anchor for that.
There's actually no specific policy on where it's supposed to be advertised. So I feel that due to Anchor TV's filming, this is adequate representation to the entirety of the student body.
I would advise that it's not.
Well,
and I think it's easy enough to put an ad in the.
I would speak with Vice President Costa on that matter. However, that's something we'll discuss.
Just my advice.
Regardless, I met with the Committee on Academic Advising on December 3rd. That was good. It was lots of fun. We discussed issues with academic advising, hiring a new person to manage academic advising. It'll be a faculty or staff member here on campus taking a new responsibility. They'll be the chair of the Committee on Academic Advising. A lot of things that they were talking about were how many holds should a student have if they're in dual departments, should it be two releases, two blocks, etc. A lot of things that I want to be able to discuss with you guys and have more of an open conversation about. So if there's anybody who is a double major or who's in the education program and has a concentration in a specific department, that's really who it's going to affect. As far as hiring a new person, there were a lot of responsibilities thrown about what academic advising what responsibility they would have, how they would dictate it, what literally just what their responsibilities would be, who they report to, which would be Dr. Pitt. It was a lot of interesting information in working with the faculty on that aspect. I mean, I was honest with them, I'm not the perfect student, I'm far from perfect. And I said to them, you know, like, I've been on the other end where I don't know what to do with advising, so let me help you. And they were really open to having a discussion, so if anybody's ever had issues with academic advising, I have my first meeting on the 1st, which ironically is also the day that budget packets are due. Ironically, it's more coincidentally. Day budget packets are due, which leads me to my next announcement. Budget packets are due February 1st at noontime. So I need them in by then. If they're incomplete and they're not turned in by that time, all organizations that aren't there are removed from the budget process. Budget hearings are February 16th and 17th. They're on a Saturday and Sunday from 9 to 5, and me and my finance commission will be here working hard. And last but not least, I'd like to congratulate my comptroller, which Hillary kind of popped the top of my head. It's okay, I'm not mad. But Tyler is my new comptroller. He'll be taking over that position starting next week. He was I interviewed and hired him over break, and I'm looking forward to him being my new buddy, I guess. Alright, that's it.
Thank you, Treasurer Bank. Now we want to announcements. I have some leaves. This is from Faculty Representative Sarwagi. I am sorry I'm unable to make it to today's meeting. It's been really busy this semester, advising students to get into the correct classes. I plan on being there for the next week's meeting. Thank you for understanding. Can I get a motion?
Motion.
Second. Motion from President Vecchia. Second. I'll give it to Deputy Speaker Bettencourt. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Abstentions. Motion passes. To Faculty Representative Mark Gunning, he has some car trouble, so he cannot make it today's meeting.
Motion
by Representative Secretary. I'll give you the second for that one. Second from Secretary Auger. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Abstentions. Motion passes. Gonna move on to Representative LaMontagne. She cannot attend today's meeting for personal reasons.
Motion
from Secretary Auger. Second from Representative Secretary. Can I get all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Abstentions. Motion to pass it. We have a leave from Representative Gosselin. He can't make it because he's sick. Can I get a motion?
Motion.
Second.
Motion from Representative Santeri. Second from Representative Horton. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Abstentions. Motion passes. If you guys haven't figured out, I'm preparing to be an auction. Another announcement. I've been on this body since October 8th, 2008, and I'm glad to say that I'm graduating this semester. This is my last semester being on the body. So I'm the only one other than me, Dr. Tenfield, and Dr. Kane, we've only been the only guys who've been here since 2009. No one else here since 2008. Very nice.
You know, I was a freshman in 2004.
But you know what? You're a lovely alumni representative. You're always spreading the message of networking. I love
that. Do it.
Yes. Very important. Very important networking. So I have a couple of projects that I'm going to be bringing to Parliament over this semester. May pass, may fail, who knows. But since we're graduating, I feel the need to actually do some work, meet with some Parliament representatives, bipartisan, and make some changes that I see fit. You know, to really improve student government. And overall, when you improve student government, what are you improving the student body? So that's all my announcements. And we'll move on to Deputy Speaker Ryan Bettencourt.
Okay. First off, I want to wish everybody, or hope everyone had a good break. Secondly, I want to wish Jordan a happy birthday.
No.
And I hope by the end of today I can hear Hillary Costa sing her happy birthday in Polish. I may not get my wish. And to my announcements, I sent an email to my Conditions and Services Committee earlier today. So Nate Bissell, Representative Bissell, Representative Lehman, Representative Carlson should get that email. I'm looking to hold a meeting next week sometime, not sure on the day, just kind of collect dates and stuff.
But at that meeting, we're looking to discuss CLOT, the weather conditions, and maybe an update on parking. So look for that stuff in the agenda in the coming weeks.
So point to the conditions committee.
Oh, right. And Representative Martin.
Yes, if you.
What's that?
No.
You're not on my email card yet, so I didn't get that to you. I'll talk to you after the meeting. And I'll update you. But that's really all I have for today. Thank you.
Thank you, Representative Deputy Speaker. We move on to the Finance Commission minutes of November 28, 2012 and December 5th, 2012. Ms. Charlie,
I just ask that these minutes be accepted with unanimous consent.
Is there any opposition to that request? No opposition? We move forward. Accepted. We're going to move on to new business. Public Relations Policy Revisions. Vice President Costa.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Okay, so in addition to adding a section to the policy, we also just did some cleanup because some of the names were out of date. If you do have it in your packet, in section 2, part E, we unitalicized the anchor, changed RIC TV to Anchor TV, and that was a hit there. In section G, the same thing, unitalicized the anchor, changed Anchor TV to RIC TV, and that was it there. The section that we added completely was I, producer, advisor, recruitment pamphlet, and flyer. I had done that back in the summer when I was first starting my term as vice president, the one where it says how to join SCG, and I also have the one that is double-sided that says what is SCG, and that was something that nobody had really made since the early 2000s, before 2003, late 90s, and I think it's something I've been handing out with every petition, and it was really helpful, and it was something to hand out at orientation and activities days as well. So that section we added, and section 5 of section 5 in general. Also unitalicized the anchor, changed Anchor TV to RIC TV, and the Office of College Communications and Marketing is now what News and PR was, but it's now Office of College Communications and Marketing, so we updated that. And it was still graphics, but we changed it to Activities Marketing. And that's it. I don't know if you just want to have those as a group accepted by as unanimous.
Give me one friendly amendment. On the letter I, and produce copies. So on that second line.
Oh, copies is
thank God, lovely Mary Sylvia for finding that one. I think I've used the word lovely way too many times tonight. Does that accept as friendly? Okay. Now you want a unanimous consent?
That's it. I just asked that these amendments be accepted with unanimous consent.
Any opposition to that? No opposition. Let's move forward. To Hillary Costa again, and she's going to be talking about her local hall. Study seating resolution.
Okay. Well, Whipple Hall second floor seating. Whereas students have no place to comfortably sit to read, use technology, or relax while waiting for class on the second floor of Whipple Hall. Whereas the Department of Communication has seen increased enrollment in its offered courses. Whereas the only seating provided on the second floor are old desks and broken chairs. Be it therefore resolved that Student Parliament, the Administration, and the Dean of Faculty of Arts and Sciences work together to search for funding to provide the second floor of Whipple Hall with basic seating and tables for student use. Sincerely, Hillary Costa, Vice President at Large. I'm a communications student, and one thing that I noticed is that a lot of students want to hang out and be in the communications building, but there's no place for them to do that besides sitting in the computer lab, maybe. And as far as the increased enrollment that I talked about, I noticed in one of my classes that I started on Tuesday that the nursing program is now requiring its students to take the interpersonal communication class, which is all about communication within relationships. And that class had about 32 people in it. So that, and the fact that we're getting all these departments coming into communication because communication is such a universal skill says a lot. And I don't know, how many of you here have taken a class in communications building? Can I show hands? So you know that upstairs on the second floor against the wall when you first come up the stairs, they have two ripped and tattered chairs from the 70s that rock like they have hydraulics on them, and they have a table from your grandmother's living room, and they have an old desk sitting out there. And I know that, you know, incredibly they took out the lockers, or Engage took out the lockers and put a bench, but you can tell when there's a changeover class because people just pile up in that space and they're just standing there. And I know that people want to just sit and maybe use their laptop or something like that, but it's a communications building. There's no place for these people to just sit and maybe communicate. So what I was hoping was that, I mean, I know that it's on the renovation list, but then again, so is the student union too, and I want something to buy time until Whipple Hall can reach its full potential. So you all know what it looks like. I know that it's gonna be tough to find funding because we're really strapped. Not just us personally, but the college as a whole. But I think this is something that will bolster the community in Whipple Hall, and not just Whipple Hall, but the community that's growing that uses the facility. So I'll field any questions or comments.
Well, we have a motion from Hillary Costas.
Motion, yes.
Second from Treasurer Vick. Now we'll lead to discussion.
Just as a comm major, I love this idea. That's all I got. But
thank you.
Any further discussion? No further discussion. All those in favor of approving this resolution say aye.
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 All opposed say no. Abstentions? This resolution passes. Now move on to administrative update. Dr. Gary Country.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Two items for you tonight. The first one is a carryover, and that is the shuttle service, which is underway again. But one piece of it that's different than last semester is that it's going to be on half-hour intervals, so that it can start at 7:30 a.m. at the transportation center, the new transportation center, and then every half hour, you know, on the half hour, be back up there, so that folks that are on campus will have a better sense of when it's going to be getting to the student union, for instance. The other piece of it, it's the same company as last year, the other piece of it is that they are in the process of purchasing a GPS system, portable, so that if they have to switch buses, they can just move the GPS system. Once that is available, then with the help of Dr. Kane, we'll have a communication out to all students giving out the necessary information to make use of the GPS system with the phone apps and so on. The service right now is slated to run until about April 12, I think 12 or 14, whatever it is, the warm weather will be here. By then, but we decided not to extend it beyond that point. That's probably, 2 weeks before the end of classes for the semester. But that's an update. We have talked, but we have not figured out how there's one extra stop, which is going to be at the Sherlock Center, based upon the request of the folks at the Sherlock Center. The one other thing that we've talked about that we haven't been able to figure out, some of you and some others had emailed me about, can the shuttle take us off campus? Given the nature of the shuttle, we haven't been able to figure that out, but we're continuing to talk with the owners, the operators of the shuttle, about how could we do that in some very limited way. If we can, we'll experiment with it during this cycle to learn, and then perhaps put it in as part of a plan for next year. So that's the shuttle. The other item that I wanted to mention, Dr. Pitt actually asked me to mention, apparently there were some classrooms in a couple buildings today that were without heat. Do any of you know that? What building?
Craig Lee.
Craig Lee, and then the Foreman Center, I think, was the other building. But anyway, Dr. Pitt said he believes, from the information he's got, that the problems have been resolved. But because I did not know about this, I have no other information there. But he was concerned that you all know that apparently we've had some issues with heat in a couple of the buildings. But I'm sure if we have, that they're working on it, because it's so damn cold outside. Buildings to be without heat. So anyway, we'll see what tomorrow brings besides more cold weather. that concludes my comments, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, Dr. Benfield. Treasurer Day.
I actually, just a concern, I was in the classroom in Clark Science the other day, and there was an issue with the lighting.
The projector was going in line.
So, were you in Clark 106?
I was in Clark 128.
Regardless, in Clark, there's an issue with some of the lights. At least for me, it was overhead lighting. You're having an issue with a projector, but there's a couple of classrooms where the overhead lighting is an issue. I just wanted to bring that to attention because it's actually really distracting from what we're trying to do with class. I mean, I placed a call to physical plant, and I mean, I have the ability to do that. So I called physical plant and asked if they could get someone over there. I don't know if that'll happen anytime soon, but I just figured something should be brought up.
Are the lights out, you mean?
Everybody in the room probably knows, like, when you have a fluorescent light and, like, one of the bulbs is, like, flickering overhead, it's actually, like, really dizzying and it's, like, a buzz. And it impacts my ability to actually focus on what's on the screen in front of me. I'm in an art history class and I can't pay attention for the life of me. And the kid sitting next to me was like, now that you pointed it out, I'm lost. Like, I can't do it. And a couple of other kids said something at the end of class, so I wanted to bring it up.
Representative Nixon.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. This is going to almost sound not serious, but there's just like such a ring of truth to this. If you follow hashtag Rick Problems on Twitter, you will find out about all of these things, like, as they happen. And I mean, like, I'm not saying you should purposely like sit around on Twitter, but like, maybe like, just like, if you have a student in your office, just be like, hey, yeah, follow that and see if something legitimate pops up. Because people aren't, that's just the way kids are. Like, they're not gonna come to you and complain. They're gonna post about it on Twitter, and that's how they're gonna get their kicks and fame. So, in all honesty, like, if you check that, that's probably where you're gonna see things like, oh, like, the food was spoiled in Donovan today. And some of them are legit, some of them aren't gonna be. They're gonna be like, oh, the trailer's backed up and it's not. But, I'm serious. I don't have the canes on Twitter, so.
Hey, I gave you a shout out. I was working and I saw you on one of the patients' televisions.
Oh, yes.
I heard your voice resonating within me.
Next is at Rick, Dean of Students. Oh, sorry.
You see me?
Because you don't have a Twitter.
I have a flip phone. It's better than Dr. Penfield's. He has no phone.
Our staff are Mark Berlucci. Sorry.
The college does have some systems in place for work orders, and we do have a tracking system just so everybody knows. So, when the college puts a work order in for lights that are broken or a projector, I'll call it AV because I'm old school, but the AV department, the user services, they use it also. So when we put things in the system, when things are broken, we can track them to see how many days it hasn't been completed. There's a survey once it does get completed that we're satisfied with the completion of the work. So it's kind of a new system. All the staff people have been trained at the college. Anybody can input it if we have a college email account. So there is a system. We don't have to rely on social networks to see that things get done. So that being said, that wasn't on my list of items, but as it came up, I'll address that. Some of you may know, some of you don't. I'm our staff rep, but Mike Ogle, great guy that worked in the dining center as an assistant director, left the college, had a great opportunity to leave, and so over break, he's gone. So a lot of students are disappointed. They liked working with them, especially the student organizations that ordered food through EMS. And if you ever had a dinner event, he was there to handle it. And so the dining center, I'm sure, will have some new faces soon in there, trying to fill in for Mike. And he did a great job for the last 2 years. So that being said, just for the notes. I usually say at this time of the year, things happen really quick. The semester's gonna be over before you know it. It's 15 weeks. The nice weather hopefully will be coming sooner than this just this weekend, so I don't have to spend so much money on oil. But it happens quickly, and I think just to touch on what Kyla was saying, you know, she wants things to happen because before you know it, you're gonna be graduating, and I hope that's going to be great for most of you. That's what you're going to be concentrating on. So especially at the beginning of the semester, if you can get some of these things, some of these items, that some of these goals that you have done at the beginning of the semester, make the rest of the semester a lot more fun. So saying on fun, just to let everybody know officially, we did sign a contract over break for a concert in the Rec Center at 8 p.m. April 11th. That's a Thursday evening. Your $70,000 is at work. It doesn't go very far. It sounds like a lot of money, but when you do a concert, we will probably spend every dollar to put on that event. In terms of promoting the event, you have a committee. You have a chair of that committee, and she will be funneling out the promotional information. I know some of that information is already going out on social networks, when tickets are going to be on sale, opening act, prices. Please wait for that committee to announce, make that announcement of who the performers are.
It's out.
And it shouldn't be.
It shouldn't be.
It should be coming from the committee once that's done. So if you have those things out there, you may want to correct them or take them down because it may not be accurate. So that being said, I am done. Thank you.
Student activities. Send the email out.
That wasn't me. That's a different department. It was not me.
I know.
The administration is aware that we are doing an event. They were aware once we signed the contract.
We are.
I have an email. You can hide it. I'll pull it up. I can track that, Dr. Pettigrew. But we do have a performer. Please just wait until that committee makes that announcement.
Congratulations to everybody who did well last semester academically. We always like to see, first and foremost, good grades by students. I know the president's interested in that. I think some people around this table made Dean's List. How many people know what Dean's List is? Give it to me. What is it?
Please didn't ask us.
You have what? Rob, what kind of grade point average do you have to have?
3.0.
When you make Dean's List, you actually get a notation on your transcript that says for that semester that you made Dean's List. And you may notice that on the college's homepage website, there's a link there to a whole list of students who have made Dean's List. So we try to keep that updated. There are a couple of caveats with respect to Dean's List, a couple of, I guess, rules. The first is that a student, in order to make Dean's List, you have to be full-time. So a student who takes 3 credit hours and gets an A in the class does not make Dean's List. And they have to be a degree student. I had a student come in the other day who actually registered for full-time course load, was given a grade in 3 of her 4 classes, but because, and then the fourth one, the faculty member just never submitted the grade, and so since she wasn't full-time with those 3 classes, she actually didn't make Dean's List, and then the grade was posted, and she should have been eligible for Dean's List, so we had to go back and do some updating. So sometimes there are some issues that come up that we have to resolve on our end to sort of fix the record, but it all works out. So, but anyway, for those of you who made it, congratulations. Just to follow up a couple of things that we were kind of talking about, we talked a little bit about the campus shuttle, and related to that are other transportation services on campus. You may have heard over break that Zipcar was bought out by Avis, I believe. But I've talked to our representative at Zipcar, and she says that will mean absolutely no changes in how we conduct service for as far in the future as she can see, and she's projecting a year and a half out anyway before Avis even gets around to seeing if they want to make any changes. So we went through some usage data with respect to how many students are registered with Zipcar, and it's probably only, I think it was only something like 60 students have actually taken out a membership. They do offer some incentives if people are interested in that. Basically, I think the first time you sign up to to use Zipcar, there's a membership fee, but then you're automatically, your account is credited more than that membership fee, so you basically get to use the car for free, you know, until you exhaust more than whatever it is, $30 or $40. And there are other incentives that they expect to be offering throughout the semester that obviously will advertise that people might want to look into. We were talking a little bit about buildings and renovations and what's happening. Everybody knows, of course, that question three passed last semester. That's going to mean renovations for Craig Lee and Gage. And I think we're trying, as a college, we're still trying to figure out which building will go first and how will it all happen and where will we move classrooms and those kinds of activities. But the one thing I think everybody has to understand is when you undertake these renovation projects, there's a lot of things that need to be orchestrated. There's a lot of, we have to sort of figure out where, again, the classrooms will go if we're going to close down a section of a building and completely gut it like we're doing with the art center. And as you can imagine, because space is limited, we can't renovate all of the buildings at the same time. We have to sort of take turns and figure out a schedule. And the reason I bring that up is because if you haven't sort of figured it out, I don't think we've talked about this before, but it has implications, of course, for the student union and the student union renovation expansion project that we've talked about. The college only has so many people to sort of oversee and supervise these projects. And again, it would be really impossible for us to have the Art Center, Gage, Craig Lee, and the student union all under construction at the same time. Where would people park? Where would we put classrooms? You know, where would students go? All of those kinds of things. So this body has been very instrumental in trying to move a renovation expansion project for the student union forward. That continues to remain on the list, but the timetable now will likely change a little bit and probably push it back a little as we try to work in the renovation projects for Craig Lee and Gage Hall before that. So I felt, you know, I think we've talked about this with the executive board, so we've obviously talked about it a lot in the college administration, but I'm wondering if we really sort of communicated that to the student community, government, parliament, and the student body, and I just felt like you all kind of need to know where we're at with all of that. And I think that concludes my announcements.
I'm on my representative.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I just have like a bunch of really brief ones, I guess. First of all, just kind of an FYI, alumni events are actually really fun. They're like networking events, but they have them at places like David Buster's where there's all you can eat cheese platters and great things like that. So, I mean, and they give you like bags full of coupons to the mall. I mean, I got these shoes like 75% off. Like, heck yeah. Thanks, alumni. And I got my resume looked at for free, and I got to exchange business cards with real working professionals. So, when you're an alumni, and some of you will be in 4 months, go. It's worth it, because I was the only person there who graduated within the last 9 years or 10 years or so. And everyone else that was there was older, which worked to my advantage, because they were looking for the younger faces. So you go, and you basically you win, and you get free food. So that's awesome. I'm dead serious. And you also, if you have received a scholarship through Renown College, you may meet the people who donated the money. Like I met the people in charge of the Shapiro Fund who donate to the education students. Some students receive a scholarship in memory of one of the former teachers at Henry Barnard Elementary School, and I met the man who supports that. So it was really cool to sit down and talk to him and find out all his great Rick memories. Yay, seniors, on that note. I would tease Jordan and say happy birthday, but she's gone. But happy birthday, Jordan.
Hi.
And also happy birthday, Rob Santuri, a day late, a buck short, but I mean, hey, happy birthday. I loved, VP Costa, I loved the resolution. I mean, because why not for Quipple, right? throw it out there, I didn't do it. That's the kind of stuff we need. I mean, simple resolution, now something's gonna get done. Now if you're an underclassman in communications, you're gonna have a great place to hang out in Whipple Hall, and you're not gonna have to go over to Alger and try to like fit amongst the people in 7 different majors crammed into that building with 2 floors. So, awesome. I guess the only other 2 things I had. One, in local news, yay Rhode Island for bringing that marriage equality bill unanimously to the floor, because I've been waiting for that since God knows when. And my second question is, am I able to assist as the Illinois representative on resolutions?
Yeah,
of course.
I was just wondering that because I was tempted to bring in something and I was like, I have this really good idea, but I don't know, that may be totally out of line.
No.
So I may be bringing you guys something for next week. We shall see. It may be excellent, but that's pretty much all my announcements other than, yay, awesome student leaders, one more semester. No, I'm really always this happy. I just went to the gym, so like, you know, all that serotonin and stuff, like, yeah.
He has a full-time job and still wants to do a resolution. That's awesome. No, that's really awesome. Appointments, resignations, and vacancies.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I have several appointments. I would like to hire Caitlin Hurd as our communications director, as well as Tyler Dean as our comptroller. Congratulations. I would like to appoint Rebecca Allen to the Elections Commission. I would like to appoint Laura Howard, Rebecca Allen, and William Gorton Jr. to Public Relations. I would like to appoint Sean Brelsford to the Academic Standing Committee. To the Curriculum Committee, I'm going to butcher these names, Adewale Akinbi and Asoe Iribor. To the Committee on Student Life, Michael Almonte, and to the Advisory Committee on Undergraduate Admissions Policy, Michael Almonte. And that concludes my appointments.
Okay, thank you, President Fernandez.
Thank you.
Any opposition to any of those appointments? No opposition to those appointments, except. Issues of Parliament members, if you've got an issue, please raise your card. We just have one issue. Oh, sorry. All right, so Representative Carlson.
I just want to say, as someone who signed and created the CLET resolution, had I known who to have talked to afterwards, once it was approved, I would have sent an email out, I would have sent a phone call. I wasn't sure where to go from there. I didn't know what to do after that, so I'm not saying Kyla, like, I'm at you for anything, whatever. Just saying, you know, had someone had said, oh, okay, this is who needs to go to talk to them now, like, I would have gone and talked to someone.
May
like,
I respond, Mr. Speaker?
Well, are you going to your point?
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, you know, if resolution comes up and, like, whoever signs it wants to kind of pursue that further because they were the ones who signed it, then, you know, maybe someone who knows who they should talk to should come up to, like, to whoever, like someone like me who signed the resolution said, hey, you know, you can talk to this person, like here's how you contact them.
Right, and you make an excellent point, and that is what I was trying to get at by creating these little subcommittees, is that everybody wants to volunteer all these ideas, but no one wants to follow up on them. And I can't follow up on six ideas, I just can't.
Yeah, and I think if they
And I don't feel like I'm not an approachable person, that I know who to talk to, that's why I'm a president,
yeah.
So.
No, I think if they were willing enough to volunteer an idea,
mm-hmm.
they should be willing enough to send an email or at least try and figure out, you know, what's going on.
Definitely.
Thank you, Representative Carlson. We're going to move on to the Treasury. Birthday girl, Treasury Day.
Well, if you want to, yeah, I'll go first. Yeah.
Okay.
Just
hurry up, okay?
Anyways, I just wanted
to. Okay,
sorry. I just want to say that in each of my first classes, back this semester, I made it a point to talk to a couple people in my classes and just see if they're in clubs, see if they know about clubs, see if they're interested in getting into clubs. And I met a couple of cool people. Definitely made some good friends. I just want to say that I suggest that everyone does the same. We're always looking to get new people around. And if you're afraid of being that guy, that's what we're all here for. Just get up in front of your class, or just if you work in a group, just offer the helping hand to your other students in your other classes and stuff. It's a good way to meet people. So I just wanted to leave you guys with that. That's it.
Not all of you perhaps are aware, but two members of this body received some recognition
at the very end of last semester. That is that Marcy Diaz received the Bucci Award and Robert Sanchez at the other end of the table received the Santos Award. The Bucci Award is named after Frank Bucci, who was here as the director of admissions about 45 years ago and retired as vice president for student affairs from Kutztown State University in Pennsylvania about 7 or 8 years ago. His family established the award in recognition of his work here at the college. And Matt Santos is newly appointed by Governor Chafee to the board, whatever it's going to be called, the Board of Governors for Elementary, Secondary, and Higher Education. And he worked here at Rhode Island College in various capacities through the year. He was the director of Weber Hall in 1976 when I arrived, before all of you were born, as Jordan would say. And his wife worked in the Donovan Dining Center for years and years. And whenever there was a labor issue, she was usually at the front of the line carrying the signs that you're going on strike, right?
And she'll admit to that.
But Robert Sanchez was the recipient of that award, and I thought that we'd want to congratulate each of them on their record. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
And they made the dean's list.
Controller Dean, I just want to say thank you for the appointment, and I truly appreciate the opportunity to be your comptroller.
That's awesome.
He's a keeper.
Where are they going for the day?
God, this took so long. One, I want to give a happy birthday shout out to Alyssa because tomorrow's her birthday, and she's working a really long time tomorrow, and I felt bad because I had to be up at 10 a.m. working at 8 a.m. working my job, so I was like, holla. So happy birthday to you, girl. Second was thank you for all your happy birthday wishes. Third is we're going to Fat Belly's afterwards, so if you want to come, come on down to Fat Belly's Providence, because that's where I'll be, and I have tons of people I don't know going. You're all welcome to come and join the Student Community Government Treasurer celebrate her 23rd birthday, and hopefully we will hear a Polish happy birthday tonight. Motion to adjourn! Yes!
Second, Representative Santari. I like this.
Alright.
All the favors say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Abstention. Everyone please stay seated for roll call.